Hello and welcome to V-Spec Performance in Melbourne, home of probably the world's greatest collection of GT-Rs, not necessarily in number, but in quality. Having an open day today, so let's go inside and have a look around. It's in the eastern suburbs of Melbourne. Got a couple of exotics over here, which I'll take you through later, but in here are some of the world's rarest, most expensive GT-Rs. So there's something to my left which I'll come back to, so let's go around here. We start with an R33 Nismo 400R. 44 of these were built. This is number 7. Been lucky enough to drive this car. It is pretty damn awesome. For those who don't know, a 400R was the poster car for the original Gran Turismo. It's a very special car. It was kind of built using bits from the Nissan Le Mans campaign in 95-96. So this has got a 2.8 litre RBX engine, which is pretty cool. Every part of this car is different basically to a regular GTR. You'd have to Google it to get the full list, obviously the body kit, the engine, but it's like the interior dials, the aero, the wheels, suspension, the diffs, the brake, like, it's completely different to regular R33. Very, very special car. As I said, one of 44 in the world. That's number 7. Next to it is a car that's probably even more special, if you can believe it. R34 GTR Z-Tune. It makes the 400R look positively common. There's 17 of these in the world. This is number 15. This is one of only 2 in Midnight Purple. There was only 1 in Midnight Purple, all the others are silver. So the Z-Tune story is basically Nismo wanted to do something special. It bought back a number of used, very good condition R34 GTRs and completely rebuilt them into Z-Tunes. They're all silver. This one has just been completely rebuilt by Nismo itself. So it was bought as a Z-Tune and then completely rebuilt back to like as new specification. Like the 400R, basically everything's different. For instance, look at the size of these brakes. Massive Brembo brakes, carbon fiber bits. As you can see, there's a bit of carbon fiber weave there. Carbon fiber guards, bonnets. Again, 2.8 litre engine, now called Z2. 500 horsepower, 0 to 100, you know, 3.5 seconds. Strengthened gears. Beautiful paintwork. As you can see, more carbon on the wing. Simply an amazing car, an amazing car. Rumour is this car cost, by the time it was bought and rebuilt, about $2.5 million, which is a lot of money for an R34, but it's a pretty special R34. This is a very cool car, but albeit not quite on the same level as what we've just seen. There's quite a few R34 NUR editions in here, so NUR, NUR stands for Nürburgring. It was the final iteration of the R34, built in 2002. This hero colour, Millennium Jade. They made 500 V-Specs and 250 M-Specs. M were more comfort oriented. They had, you know, more comfortable seats, softer suspension tune, that sort of thing. I think there are, looking around here, I think there are four or so NURs in here, which, you know, out of a total build number of 750, to have 4 or 5 in the same place is pretty remarkable. This is a 2020 GTR Nismo, one of the first in the country. As you can see, it's got the new aero and the carbon ceramic brakes, which dictate the Nismo. You'll see a review of this car in the next issue of Motor, funnily enough. Not a GTR, but very, very cool, is this FDR X7. As new, I think it's got 18,000 Ks on it. It's absolutely mint. You do not see RX7s in that condition. So V-Spec is a performance workshop. As you can see, a couple of hoists here, a couple of customer cars, focusing on GTRs mainly, as you can well imagine. Here we have an RB26 with a whole bunch of Nismo parts on it. Just come out of that car right there. Very cool. Another super special car. The Mines Ultimate Response. So you might be familiar with this car, or its sister car, from the Best Motoring DVD. If not, just Google or YouTube Best Motoring. Mine's GT-R. You'll see a car that looks exactly like this come up with the Japanese racing drivers screaming because it's so damn fast. Having driven this car, I can fully concur with their feelings. It is extremely quick. So this is not the best motoring car. It is a sister car, supposedly built for the boss of Mines, the tuning company Mines, as a sort of street version. It doesn't have a roll cage, slightly different suspension. They built three apparently. In this spec, you can go and order all the different bits, but in terms of their actual car together, this is one of three. It's insanely fast. It's 441 kilowatts or so. The engine alone costs like 90 grand. Shortened gearing, which helps it may be so quick. It is unbelievable. It's pretty much as quick as a R35. It feels as quick as R35, only with a 6-speed gearbox, and yeah, very, very special car. Next to it, a couple of NERS in the Millennium Jade, again tuned by Mines. So as you can see, famous Millennium Jade paintwork. It's got the different engines in there. So they had N1 engines. There was an N1 right over there, speaking of special GT-Rs, which had different turbos, strengthened block, all that sort of stuff, which leads us neatly on to the N1. The N1 GT-R is basically the best factory GT-R. It was kind of built for homologation for endurance racing. Again, stronger block, stronger engine, no ABS, no aircon, that sort of thing, carbon bonnet with this vent in it. Again, all the sort of mods you'd normally make to homologate a car for racing. Next to it, another famous tuner, Tommykaira. Might be a name you'd know from Gran Turismo. I'm gonna follow this guy. Here's his Instagram. I'm afraid I don't know a lot of details on this. It's very rare cars, only a couple in Australia. But a very cool thing. Like Tommykaira, again, like Mines, it's a sort of complete package. You get lots more power, bespoke body kit. Again, so there's no Nissan badges on it. It's a Tommykaira. It's kind of like a secondary vehicle manufacturer kind of thing. A recent addition to the V-Spec fleet is this very cool KGC10 2000 GTX. It's not a GTR, the famous Hakkasuka, which had an S20 engine. This has, as you can see, KGC10. It's where the GTR story kind of started. Not with this car, because it's a GTX, but the KPGC10 was the first GTR, dominated racing in Japan for years and years and years, almost went unbeaten. Beautiful car, cool inline six cylinder on carbs. Very nice example. Now, we've saved the best for last. Again, so like you say, there's not a whole heap of cars in here, but the cars that are in here are amazingly special. And probably the most special of them all is a car that just arrived a few days ago. The HKS Zero-R. Now, probably not a very well-known car, and that's because there's only four of them. So, this is one of four. Story is that HKS wanted to build this car and release it in the early 90s, as, like the Z-Tune, as a tuned-up factory GT-R kind of thing. It would have been its own thing. It's not a Nissan, it's an HKS car. They went over the whole car, chassis, brakes, interior, body kit. As you can see, there's no Nissan badges on this car. It's an HKS car, Zero-R. Really well done. You know, all the body kit panels are stamped with Zero-R. There are four of these cars. Why they didn't get made was because they would have had to crash test them as like a secondary vehicle manufacturer. Very expensive to do that, killed the project. One went to the Sultan of Brunei. The other three apparently just sat around at HKS not doing a lot. Until recently, they rebuilt them. Went over them head to toe, completely rebuilt them to as new. Again, you can see Zero-R badging on the engine. About 600 horsepower. Again, it's not like the Mines car. The power figures aren't crazy. It's not like they're 12 or 1300 horsepower, but they're completely streetable cars. They work just like a factory car. In the way they work, they don't differ at all from a standard GT-R, it's just they're a lot quicker. So this is an extremely special car. So V-Spec bought this at auction recently. So yeah, absolute pièce de resistance of the collection. And that's why this collection is so special. To have an R320R, a 400R, and a Z-Tune all in the same building is remarkable. So, you know, one of four, one of 44, one of 17, all in this little Melbourne workshop. You can drop in and see them. V-Spec guys are very friendly. We'll finish off with something a little bit different. So the owner of V-Spec is a big car head. Loves his cars, loves his supercars. We have an AMG GT-R over here. SVJ Aventador Coupe, very hard to miss. And this isn't V-Spec's, but a friend's, although they do have a Pista. It's a 488 Pista, no stripes, quite rare. Usually see them with stripes, but this also has the carbon rim option, which come from Carbon Revolution, which is just down the road in Geelong. So presumably the wheels go from Geelong over to Maranello, and then they come all the way back to Melbourne. So a very cool trio to sign off with. So there you go, guys. Hope you've enjoyed a quick look at the V-Spec Open Day. They've got some awesome GDRs. Come and check them out sometime. Until next time.